गुड इवनिंग एवरी वन, दिस इज़ अनुभव फ्रॉम डाइट टू लर्न एंड आई वेलकम यू अगेन टू द चैनल। सो टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द रोमांटिक एज पार्ट थर्ड, दैट इज द मिसलेनियस प्रोज। सो वी हैव द फॉलोइंग प्रोज राइटर्स इन द मिसलेनियस प्रोज: चार्ल्स लैम्ब, थॉमस डी क्विंसी एंड विलियम हैजलिट। नाउ वी विल डिस्कस ईच ऑफ देम वन बाय वन। ऑन योर स्क्रीन इज चार्ल्स लैम्ब, who is famous for his Dream Children, born in 1775 and died in 1834. Now discussing about the life of Charles Lamb, he was born on 10th February 1775 in Inner Temple, London. He was educated at Christ's Hospital, where he was a fellow pupil of college. He obtained a clerkship in India House in 1792. You may be asked a question in that, that who obtained a clerkship in India House? The answer is Charles Lamb. Or you may be asked the other way around, that Charles Lamb obtained a clerkship in which house? The answer would be India House. In September 1796, Mary Lamb murdered the mother of Charles in a frenzy and had attacks of insanity. She appears in Lamb's works as Cousin Bridget. Lamb retired in 1825 and died in 1834 at Edmonton, London. The first of his essays appeared in the London magazine in 1820. The original series of essays was published as the Essays of Ilya in 1823 and the last Essays of Ilya in 1833. The other famous pieces are The Old Familiar Faces, Two Hester, Tales from Shakespeare, Specimens of English Dramatic Poets, and a tragedy, John Woodville. On your screens is Thomas De Quincey. De Quincey was born in Manchester. When he was an undergraduate in 1804, he first became acquainted with opium. His whole money was spent. He spent 1809 to 1830 in Lake District. During this time, his devotion to opium was excessive. Then he moved to Scotland, where he died on 8th December 1859. He is famous for his work, The Opium Eater. The work that made his name was Confessions of an English Opium Eater in 1821, which appeared in the London magazine. Other works of De Quincey are The English Mail Coach in 1849, Suspiria de Profundis in 1845, and On Murder, considered as one of the fine arts, in 1827 and second part in 1839. This essay on murder of considered as one of the fine arts is the favorite topic of NET. On your screens is William Hazlitt. So William Hazlitt was born at Maidstone, England. He met Coleridge in 1798. In 1812, he turned into a lecturer and theater critic. From 1814 until his death, he contributed to the Edinburgh Review. His other articles appeared in the Examiner, the Times, and the London Magazine. Hazlitt is mainly known for his essays published between 1817 to 1825. His famous lectures are Characters of Shakespeare's Plays in 1817, The English Poets, 1818, The English Comic Writers, 1819, and The Dramatic Literature of the Age of Elizabeth in 1820. His best essays were collected in The Round Table, published in 1817, Table Talk, published in 1821-22, and The Spirit of the Age, published in 1825. Now we will discuss about the other writers of prose. These are Walter Savage Landor, Francis Jeffrey, John Wilson, Sidney Smith, विलियम कॉबेट, जॉन जी लॉकहार्ट एंड द हिस्टोरियंस दैट इंक्लूडेड एच एच मिलमैन, जॉर्ज ग्रोट एंड हेनरी हेलम. वाल्टर सैवेज लैंडोर इज पॉपुलर फॉर हिज पोएम्स जैबिर, हेलेनिक्स, लास्ट फ्रूट ऑफ एन ओल्ड ट्री एंड हेरोइक आइडियल्स. हिज बेस्ट ड्रामा इज काउंट जूलियन. जेफरी वॉज वन ऑफ द फाउंडर्स ऑफ द एडिनबर्ग रिव्यू एंड प्ले ए कंसिडरेबल पार्ट इन द पैसेज ऑफ द रिफॉर्म बिल ऑफ 1832. जॉन विल्सन वॉज अपॉइंटेड इन 1820 एज ए प्रोफेसर एट एडिनबर्ग यूनिवर्सिटी. हिज अर्ली पोएम्स आर द आइल ऑफ साल्म्स एंड द सिटी ऑफ द प्लेग. ही इज फेमस फॉर वन नॉवल द ट्रायल्स ऑफ मार्गरेट रिड्से. सिडनी स्मिथ असिस्टेड इन द लॉन्चिंग ऑफ द एडिनबर्ग रिव्यू. हिज टू फेमस कलेक्शंस आर लेटर्स ऑन द सब्जेक्ट्स ऑफ द कैथोलिक्स टू माई ब्रदर अब्राहम हु लिव्ड इन द कंट्री बाय पीटर प्लिम्बले इन 1807 टू 08 एंड हिज विट एंड विजडम इन 1860. लॉकहार्ट बिकेम द कॉन्ट्रीब्यूटर टू द ब्लैकवुड मैगजीन इन 1817 and was the editor of the Quarterly Review from 1825 to 1853. He is famous for his four novels, Valerius, Adam Blair, Ancient Spanish Ballads, and Peter's Letters to His Kinsfolk. He also wrote Memoirs of the Life of Sir Walter Scott, which is very important. William Cobbett was a journalist. He started the Porcupine, Cobbett's weekly political register. His fame rests upon his Rural Rights in 1830, which gives an account of the English counties he traveled. Now we will come to the historians. The famous works of Milman are Tragedy Fazio in 1815, The History of the Jews in 1829, and The History of Latin Christianity in 1854-55. Grote's only famous work is A History of Greece, a too long work. Henry Hallam contributed to the Edinburgh Review. His two most important works are The Constitutional History of England from the accession of Henry VII to the death of George II and The Introduction to the Literature of Europe in 15th, 16th and 17th centuries. The Die to Learn app is now on Play Store. You can download it from Play Store and have a look into a variety of subjects like economics, commerce, and paper one as well. Thank you.